Hello, and welcome to the Probe Virtual College Fair. Thank you for joining us. A few housekeeping announcements before we get started. You can use the Q&A button on your screen to type your questions to our presenters at any time. In the Q&A, you can designate your question to a specific school or schools, or you can ask a more general question for all of our representatives to answer about their programs. Your camera and your microphone are off, so the panelists cannot see or hear you. And this is one of many sessions that have happened as a part of the programming. Like all of the others, it's being recorded and it will be available within about a week's time at the same website where you registered, strivescan.com/probe. I'd now like to turn it over and welcome our first school presenting today. It's Florida International University.
Thank you. Welcome everyone, good evening. Thank you for joining us. A little nervous, no pressure, I'm going first. But my name is Jahara Graham. I am representing Florida International University. I'm the Assistant Director of Admissions. FIU is Miami's only public research institution. So these are just some fun facts. We are pretty large. We're about the third largest public university in the country. So really large. Over 200 different majors to choose from. We have everything from bachelor's to doctoral programs. That does include a College of Medicine and a College of Law as well, that has the highest bar passing rate in Florida. So we do like to brag. We're a tier one research institution. We have 18 Division I sports, NCAA if you're into that. We do have athletic scholarships. I'll get into that a little later. And then over 300 clubs and organizations to choose from. So these are some of our colleges and schools. We have the College of Art, Science, and Education, which is CASE. That picture is showing our one of our mock trial rooms, which is really cool. College of Business is pretty much our main attraction, one of them, I should say. But International Business is ranked number 2 in the nation. We have Architecture and the Arts. What you see there is our annual Walk on Water event, where the students have to walk across the lake with like flotation shoes that they've made, and some fall in, but the first person across does receive a scholarship. So it's a really cool event. College of Engineering and Computing, you see our wall of wind. It simulates up to Category 5 hurricanes. We are in Miami, so we do like to be prepared. So our students do a lot of hands-on work in the community as well. SIPA, School of International Public Affairs, School of Hospitality. Right there is our restaurant that's on campus. It's completely student run, from the menu to the chefs, everything. And we do partner with the South Beach Wine and Food Festival. So we do have a College of Social Work, Nursing and Medicine there. You can see our dummies, our star lab. So pretty much those dummies breathe, sweat, give birth. They do everything that people do. So it's a really hands-on experience for our students. Again, the College of Law, and we do have an honors college. So a little bit about student life. FIU is very, very vibrant. We're, again, in Miami, so there's a lot to do both on campus and in the city. So you have a few pictures here, but basically campus life. We have kayaking at our North Campus, Biscayne Bay. Arts and culture, we do have a museum both on campus at the main campus and on South Beach. So those are free to students. Again, we do participate in the South Beach Wine and Food Festival. So our students work hand in hand with your top chefs, and it's a lot of good food. Sports, again, NCAA Division I, but if you don't want to do NCAA, we do have intramural sports as well. And then over 300 different clubs and organizations to choose from. And this includes honor societies, Greek societies, and we have all the councils represented. As far as housing is not required for freshman students, but it definitely is available. You can see one of our residence hall, one of our rooms there. All the housing is apartment or suite style. So there's no hall bathrooms or anything like that. At the bottom is our honors hall. So that's kind of what it looks like. They're all very, very modern. They have HBO, Wi-Fi, all that fun stuff. And then we do have meal plans. So we have over 35 different restaurants on campus. So you can definitely find a lot of places to eat. Everything from Chick-fil-A, 3 Starbucks, Moe's, Panda Express, you name it, we have it on campus. So that's housing. So when it comes to admissions, the website is there, admissions.fiu.edu. You can find everything. But admissions is very simple. We are still accepting applications summer, which is early fall, In fall, April 1st are the application deadlines, and then spring is December 1st. Completely online application. There's no essay, no letters of recommendation. So you apply online, send the $30 application fee or fee waiver. We do accept those. SAT or ACT test scores, we do super score. So send as many as you have and then submit your transcripts. And we're looking at the weighted GPA. So if you have honors, AP courses, anything like that, we do take that into consideration. As far as cost, this is the yearly cost for undergraduate based on 30 credits. So essentially a full year, give or take. Florida residents, it's about $6,500 for the full year. And then out of state and international students, about $18,900. So it's fairly affordable in terms of tuition. The scholarship database is at the bottom, fiu.academicworks.com. That has all of our scholarships, merit-based, department-based, everything is on that website there. Fun fact, about 50% of our students graduate with no debt. So we do give out a lot of scholarship dollars. And that is pretty much it, just to wrap it up. I know that was rapid fire. So if you have any questions, you can definitely contact the Office of Admissions. Our phone number is there. Our general email address is there. My personal email is the jhgram@fiu.edu. We are still doing virtual everything, virtual visits, virtual tours, virtual information sessions. Regular tours are coming back, so feel free to come to sunny South Florida. But if you want to visit virtually, you can set up one of those on that website. And then lastly, social media, everything is there. FIU Jahara, I don't follow back, don't worry. But I post a lot of good information. FIU Instagram is the general page for the university, and then Join FIU is run by our tour guides. So if you want like a student perspective, if you have any questions, drop them in the Q&A, and thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Tahara, for sharing FIU with all of us tonight. Our next presentation is going to be Columbia College.
Hi, everyone. I hope you all are doing well this evening. So just to go over a few things about Columbia College. Of course, like I said, it's going to be pretty quick, but we are a small private liberal arts institution. We're located in Columbia, South Carolina. Again, we're fairly small, so our student body is about 1,000, but you're getting that hands-on personalized attention in the classroom, and a lot of students are really enjoying that hands-on experience and having that one-on-one time with their professors. As far as undergraduate programs, we have over 30 different majors for students to pick from. Some of our most popular ones are anything within the education field, the health sciences. We have a brand new nursing program that we partnered with our technical school here in Columbia with. And then we also have a business entrepreneurship route as well that is pretty popular. Overall, we do have a fairly high job placement rate and graduation rate. I believe our graduation rate is 87%, and then our job placement, especially within specific majors, is basically 100%, I can guarantee it. Moving on, in terms of our athletics, we were previously a women's college. We are now a co-ed institution, so personally, I'm really excited, and the campus is excited to welcome a more diverse student population. Not only just we get to share something super special that we have at Columbia College with more students, but we also get to welcome a more diverse student population. So that's something I'm looking forward to. But with that, we do have the new establishment of athletic teams. So we are adding 4 men's teams to campus, but we do have athletic and academic scholarships available. However, those athletic scholarships are coordinated with the coaches. But if you would like to look to get recruited, please feel free to email me directly. My contact information will be at the end, and I can certainly get you in touch with someone at Columbia College. And that's also a benefit that you get working at a smaller institution. So in terms of campus life, there's always something to do. We actually just got a new director of activities. So she is on fire. She's doing stuff all the time for students. And not only is there something to do on campus, there's something to do off campus as well. We're located right in the downtown area. Not only do you have easy access to the beaches and Charleston and Myrtle Beach and the mountains and like Greenville, but you also have tons of stuff to do in Columbia. So we do have Five Points, which is kind of like the college student hangout. And then we also have the Vista. We do have University of South Carolina in our backyard, as well as Allen and Benedict University. Those are two HBCUs. And then we also have Columbia International. So we are a really big college town in Columbia. So there's never a dull moment, I can guarantee it. But we have had concerts in Columbia, like Beyonce's come, the Jonas Brothers and Ariana Grande has come to the Charlotte area. So you have easy access to do just about anything and everything in Columbia. Next, in terms of admission requirements, it's fairly simple. It's a quick, easy process, but 2.5 minimum GPA on the 4.0 scale. Anything below 2.5, we always ask for a letter of recommendation and an essay to supplement those documents. It does not guarantee admissions, but working on a small institution, you do get the benefit of having, again, that one-on-one interaction with your admissions counselor, such as myself. We are test optional. However, with nursing, that's the only program that we do require SAT and ACT test scores. And that is specifically for the technical institution that we did partner with in Columbia. This is a cost breakdown of everything in total. Something that we did add is an $800 resource and technology fee, and that is for students to have e-textbooks within their tuition. So you don't have to pay for a physical textbook. And I know this number looks really, really large, but we do offer scholarships, like I said, academically and athletically. And this is a full breakdown, but it is available on our website. This is just a quick, easy process in terms of our admissions, but our application is free to apply, and this will also be sent out to you after you apply, so feel free to take a screenshot of this if you like. I know I'm kind of starting to fly through this, but after you do apply, we do encourage students to fill out the FAFSA as well, and then make sure that FAFSA is sent in with our school code attached to it, and all students are automatically considered for scholarships when they submit their FAFSA. But just to kind of wrap up here, my name is Alexis once again. This QR code up in the top right-hand corner goes to Linktree, so it has easy access to our Instagram page, our visit page. We are doing in-person on-campus tours and events. And then if you just have any general questions, feel free to reach out to us. But this is me, and that's kind of Columbia College in a nutshell. So thank you guys. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Alexis, for sharing Columbia College with us tonight. It is great that we're already getting some questions in our Q&A. Thanks, attendees. Definitely keep those coming as each school presents. And I'm happy now to turn it over to Wake Forest University.
All right. Thank you, Jennifer. Good evening, everybody. My name is Thomas Ray. I am an assistant dean in the Office of Admissions at Wake Forest University. Wake Forest is actually located up in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, in the western third of the state, just an hour north of the largest city, of course, which is Charlotte, and about 2 hours west of our state capital, which is Raleigh. For a lot of our students, and certainly for a lot of our community members, just taking advantage of all the resources that come along with those cities, and of course, all the resources that come along in being in this kind of mountainous, being at the foot of the mountains, having access to all of the outdoors opportunities as a result is always something really attractive for our students. You'll see that we have a student population of just over 5,000 students, and they come from quite literally all over the place. And so if you're looking to engage with students who look like you, who believe like you, who think like you, or maybe you're trying to find a community that's going to challenge you in some really healthy ways, Wake Forest is definitely going to check that box. As it relates to our academic environment, which I should say, this is the thing we hang our hat on. If you know nothing else about Wake Forest, if you remember nothing else about this institution, is that we really, truly do prioritize the academics. U.S. News and World Reports has recognized us for almost three decades at this point because of that academic environment, which is, as you see in this picture here, small, based in discussion, driven by professors, not teaching assistants and not graduate students. We want you to be in conversation with folks who know what they're talking about. And so having those daily interactions with faculty members certainly mean for some really great conversations and some great relationships as well. We're a liberal arts institution, and you'll see just quickly here, we've got over 40 majors and 60 minors that span everything from business to medicine to engineering to law. You think of it as probably on our campus. There really are no schools at Wake Forest. And so what that means is that you can take whatever you want to take. You could be, for example, a music major that's also pre-med. You could be a student who's studying computer science, but also spending a lot of time in the theater department. So you're not limited in terms of what it is that you study or are able to pursue as a student on our campus. Along with those kinds of academic opportunities, we believe that you can learn anything, anywhere. And so study abroad is a big part of the Wake Forest experience too. We own some of these properties that you see here. So we own a house in Venice in London and in Vienna as well. And then we've got some really great internship opportunities for students who are hoping to spend time in our nation's capital in San Francisco, or maybe who want to spend an entire year in Copenhagen, Denmark. So again, we want you to have these experiences to accompany this kind of academic experience that you'll have. We realize, though, that your time outside the classroom is really, really important. It's something that you're looking forward to. And so you're going to find a really vibrant campus community. We too are a Division I school. We're part of the ACC. And so you might have heard of Chris Paul. You might have heard of Tim Duncan. There's also this drink, half tea, half lemonade, called the Arnold Palmer. Of course, the athlete that's named after is a Wake Forest graduate as well. So if you're looking to go to college game day, if you want to show up on the TV on Saturdays, you may very well have that opportunity as part of our campus. But I'll say too, though, we've got over 250 student organizations. So if you're thinking club sports, for example, honor societies, Greek life, I mean, service-based organizations and groups, there really are a lot of things for you to plug into as a member of our campus community. So no shortage of opportunities. And I think if I were to try to summarize Wake Forest really quickly, we're the place where you don't have to sacrifice. If you want the small feeling school, relationships with faculty, with a really good education once you graduate, and of course the support to find the jobs that you're really interested in, but you also want this big campus community. You want to be able to do just about anything and be involved in all of these organizations and have these Division I sports, have the opportunity to study abroad or to do research. Wake is going to check all of those boxes for you. It's important for me to note a couple of different things about the process of applying to Wake Forest. We accept three different applications, the Common App, the Coalition App, the Wake Forest App. To be honest, it doesn't matter which one you submit. But the more important thing that I want to quickly mention is just about financial aid. We meet 100% of your need. We meet 100% of your need. There are some people who look at the sticker price of Wake Forest and they panic, they write us off, they say, no, there's no way that's going to work. But trust me when I tell you, I speak from experience as a Wake Forest graduate myself. There are a lot of people who find that Wake Forest is much more accessible than what they thought or anticipated it to be. So as you move forward in your process, if you find that Wake Forest, again, is a place where you really want to spend time, a place that you want to commit to for 4 years, don't let that sticker price stop you, at least from applying, because you might be quite surprised to see the kind of financial aid and the kind of support that you receive from our university. This final slide that I share with you is just in regard to ways to contact us. You'll see social media on the right-hand side. I'll also share in the chat in just a second here my own contact information, so reach out to me. I'm your regional representative. I'm happy to answer questions and happy to support. The QR code actually outlines, there's a lot of good information at that particular site, from our virtual tour to all sorts of virtual sessions that we're offering as well. Certainly we look forward to engaging with you, and I look forward to answering your questions in the chat. But thanks for being here today.
Great, thank you so much, Thomas, for presenting on Wake Forest University. We are reaching our halfway point. We've heard from three great schools. We have three more to go. So I hope that we'll get more questions in the Q&A from all of our attendees. And up next, we're going to be hearing from Christian Brothers University. Oh, hold on 1 second. We just need you to unmute real fast. I just sent a little note about that.
Oh, thank you.
Great. Looks great. We can hear you too.
Awesome. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jaira Jones. I'm an admissions counselor here at Christian Brothers University. We are located in the heart of Memphis, Tennessee. So if you are looking for a great school, but also great food, CBU is the place. So we have around 1,700 students in our student body. Though we are small, we're private and liberal arts as well, and we offer a diverse student body. We have students from 28 countries, and almost half of our campus is our minority students. We are a LaSallian school, so we really value faith, community, and service, and about 22% of our campus is Catholic. For academics, CBU really offers our students rigorous academics, but also a supportive environment to make sure that they are ready for whatever career path they choose. Our student to faculty ratio is 11-1. So our students really have that opportunity to get to know professors on an individual level and receive any individualized support and attention they may need. This also allows for students to do research alongside their professors, but also receive mentorship. Our average class size pre-COVID is a 16, and we offer over 65 majors, programs, and concentrations through our academic schools, which include the School of Arts, the School of Science, the School of Engineering, and the School of Business. So our academic success rates, within 6 months of graduation, our students are employed or accepted into grad school at a rate of 95%. And we've included the rates by department. So here at CBU, of course, we really attract strong students such as yourself, but also we have dedicated faculty and staff who will go that extra mile to make sure you are successful. And we also have our career services department that connects students with internships and opportunities while they're here at CBU. They have a pretty seamless process where students can say what major they're interested in, and our career services office will give you a list of companies where you can intern. So that really makes it easy for students. Academic support services that we offer for our students include tutoring in foreign languages, in math and sciences, and in writing. We also have peer tutoring as well. And we have a disability services center for students. So we understand that college is a very challenging time. So we want to make sure that we're able to support our students as needed. Here at CBU, we offer over 60 clubs and organizations. So we offer honor societies, professional societies, special interest organizations. So that's one thing that's really cool about CBU. If there's something you're really passionate about and we don't have a club for it, you can create that club with a group of friends and leave your mark on CBU's campus. We also have an honors program for students who are interested in challenging themselves academically, and we offer Greek life as well. So for financial aid, our tuition is around $34,000 a year. We do offer scholarships for our students. And as you can see, we have two matrices. So one is including test scores here, and then the other is not. It only has GPA. So we offer up to $18,000 a year for our students. And this is, and then for the matrix without test scores, we offer up to $15,000. So all of our students do receive some sort of financial assistance through CBU, and we're always willing to work with students as well. And we offer financial aid for students who are unable to complete the FAFSA also. Admissions, our application is fairly short and sweet. You can apply directly through our website or through the Common App. We are test optional this year with an exception for the School of Science and the School of Engineering. So all you need to submit to us for general admission would be your transcripts, and we require a 2.7 GPA. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. If you have any questions regarding CBU, you can reach us at our email, admissions@cbu.edu. We would love to answer your questions and help guide you through the process.
Great. Thank you so much, Sarah, for sharing more about Christian Brothers University. We are going on to our next school, which will be the University of South Carolina. Great, Lorenzo, we can definitely see the screen share, but we just can't hear you or see you yet.
I'm sorry about that.
Great. No, I was trying to help you out there. We've got your screen and we can see and hear you now too.
All right, thank you. Hello, guys. My name is Lorenzo Myers, and I am the Georgia Regional Admissions Representative for the University of South Carolina. First, I would like to thank Alexis from Columbia College for that great introduction about the city of Columbia. The city of Columbia is located in the heart of downtown. Well, our university is located in the heart of downtown Columbia, South Carolina. With Columbia being centrally located in the state and is the state's capital, the University of South Carolina is the state's flagship public institution. We are about an hour and a half away from Charleston, South Carolina, where the beaches are held. And then we are about an hour and a half away from the mountains in Charlotte, North Carolina. So we do have a great location. Also, Columbia has so much to offer. We see a lot of students that come here for undergrad, but then also would like to stay because we do offer graduate programs. And also we do have two schools. We have a school of law and also a school of medicine. But we do see a lot of our students who come from their undergraduate career and continue to stay and build up our community here in Columbia. Here at the University of South Carolina, we have about 27,000 undergraduate students. About 58% of our students were from in-state, and then 42% of our students were from out-of-state. We do serve our in-state students first, and then we look at our qualified out-of-state students second. We do have all 50 states represented on our campus, and also 100 plus countries as well that are represented on our campus. We have to achieve the Higher Education Excellence and Diversity Award. So when you do come to our campus, you will see that our campus is truly diverse, and you will get to see others that look like you, may have the same social interests, maybe have the same religious beliefs. So you'll get to be in a community, even though you're in a larger community. We do have ways to make our campus much smaller through our living learning communities, through our Honors College, and so much more. Here are our top 10 states. We're glad to know that Georgia is our second largest out-of-state market. Right here are our 10 states that we see our students come from, and we do have a representative in each state as well. Here on our campus, we do have 56 nationally ranked programs on our campus. And although you are attending a large institution, we still give you that opportunity to have those small class sizes. So our student to faculty ratio is 17-1. Just to name a few programs that we do offer here, we do offer the number one international business program in the US. Also, we have the number one MBA international business program as well. Also with our College of Arts and Sciences, this is our largest college on our campus. Like I say, our Dollimore School of Business is truly well known. With our College of Engineering and Computing, we're the only school in the state of South Carolina that has an aerospace engineering program. Also with our College of Nursing, we have 100% pass rate on the NCLEX exam, which is the license exam that all students must take in order to practice nursing. Like I stated earlier, we do have the number one honors college for your public university since 2012. So our honors college, there is a separate application for from our general admissions application. But with our honors college, our students here on our campus have their own living and learning community. They have their own classes just solely just for the honors college students. Also, those classes are more of your discussion-based style classes. And those classes tend to have 14-1 students in those classes. But we do have the top ranked honors college in the US for a public institution. Our Capstone Scholars Program is another high ability program that we offer for our students. With our Capstone Scholars Program, this is invitation only. So in difference from our Honors College, there's an application, but with our Capstone Scholars Program, there's no separate application. And a lot of the components of our Capstone Scholars Program is done outside of the classroom. Here at the University of South Carolina, we want you to be career ready. When you step foot on our campus, we want you guys to see that return on investment. So no matter what your major or your program that you're interested in studying, you will get some type of hands-on experience learning beyond the classroom. We do offer study abroad opportunities for students. We do offer undergraduate research. We are a tier one Carnegie Research Institution. Also, we do offer job shadowing, co-op, and also industry interviews as well. Located in the heart of Columbia, South Carolina, which is the state capital, there's so many resources for our students. with student life. We have over 500 plus student organizations on campus. Only 25% of our student body is a part of a fraternity or sorority. So there's different professional organizations, student government, music club, dance club. So there's various clubs, and there's many options for students to build that sense of community at our larger institution by joining a student org on our campus. Gamecock Spirit, we have 19 collegiate D1 sports on our campus. We are in the Southeastern Conference. So if you know about football, you know that the Southeastern Conference is really well known. Also, our women's basketball team just won the NCAA Southeastern Conference tournament on Sunday. So our women's team have won that championship for 6 straight years. And so hopefully they can go to the Final Four and bring home another championship. With our housing and dining, we offer 25 residence hall options on campus for students. We do offer 30 unique dining locations as well on campus for our students. Our freshman students are required to live on campus their first year. Applying to the University of South Carolina, here are our mid-range scores. So you guys just please keep this in mind. These are our mid-range scores. Sorry, my time is getting cut short, but if you guys have any questions about the university, I will put my information in the chat. But thank you guys for being here with the University of South Carolina.
Lorenzo, thank you so much for sharing South Carolina with all of our attendees tonight and everyone watching at home. We are coming up on our sixth school of the evening. It will be Lenoir-Rhyne University. So attendees, this is a great time to get ready to listen to another great school and to also think about any questions you want to ask in the chat so our representatives can get to you and help you before we end our evening together. So Morgan, I'm going to turn it over to you for Lenoir-Rhyne.
Let me try that again, everybody. My name is Morgan Logan. Thank you so much for joining the College Fair this evening. I'm one of the enrollment management counselors at Lenoir-Rhyne, and I work specifically with students from the state of Georgia. I'm happy to have a chance to connect with you this evening. We are running a little short on time, so I'm gonna jump right into the presentation to give you guys a little bit more information about LR. So if you were like me when you were a high school student, I went to a small high school. I love that environment. I really loved being able to talk with my professors and to have a very collaborative nature in the classroom. And I loved knowing everyone. So when I went to school, I knew that going to a small college was the right fit for me. And I truly believe that that's the case for many students that are going through their college application process now. So if you think that going to a smaller, really community-driven institution would be right for you, I certainly encourage you to look at Lenoir-Rhyne and all of the other wonderful schools across the country. Talk a lot about best fit. You want to find the school that's the best fit or the right fit for you. That may be big, that may be small, but try to answer those questions and get in touch with what would be best for you as a student. Just to give you a little information about Lenoir-Rhyne, we do have approximately 2,000 students here on our campus in Hickory, North Carolina. It's comprised of both undergraduate students and graduate students. Our average class size is 17, and our student-to-professor ratio is 12 to 1. We have over 50 undergraduate majors on campus, as well as over 20 graduate studies programs. But our top programs at the undergraduate level are nursing, exercise science, biology, psychology, criminal justice, business management, and our education studies programs, so for future educators. And we have lots of things that students can be involved in outside of the classroom, including athletics at both intramural level, club level, and Division II level. We have sports like football, basketball, baseball, softball, and soccer. We also have lots of support services that students can access while they're a student at Lenoir-Rhyne. Considering academic support services, our Lure Learning Commons includes our tutoring services, also our writing center, and our speech lab on campus. And we also have our Career Development Center, where students can access things like job fairs, resume workshops, interviewing skills, things of that nature to help them prepare for what's to come following their college graduation. We also have ample undergraduate research opportunities, specifically through our science programs on campus. Of course, we offer study abroad opportunities as well throughout the entire world. Students have the opportunity to study abroad for a full semester or to take trips for just a couple of weeks, either during the semester or during the summers. We have an entire slate of music and arts opportunities on campus as well. We have instrumental ensembles like our marching band. We have vocal ensembles like our a cappella choir. We have a radio station on campus that students can be involved in, and many more. We do have over 50 clubs that students can be involved in as well, in addition to Greek life. So if you're interested in being involved in a fraternity or a sorority, if you're interested in being involved in religious life clubs or political-based clubs, then definitely look into the different options that we have at Lenoir-Rhyne. And we also have our support and wellness center on campus. So if students need things like mental health counseling, if you need to see a physician, you'll be able to have those opportunities right here on campus without going anywhere. We are offering both in-person and virtual visits. So for our in-person visits, you would come to our campus here in Hickory, North Carolina. We're offering visits Monday through Fridays, in addition to some Saturdays throughout the remainder of the semester and in the summers. We also offer virtual visits as well, if you would prefer to connect with us via a virtual format, just like you're doing tonight. To talk a little bit about the application process at Lenoir-Rhyne, we are still accepting applications for this current admission cycle, and our application for our current high school juniors will open up on August 1st of this year. And we do have a minimum GPA of 2.75 weighted, and we just need a copy of your transcript in addition to your application. So if you'd like to send test scores, a resume or an essay, or letters of recommendation, those are optional. So that's up to your choice whether you would like to send them. But in order to complete your application, we just need your application and your transcript. We do encourage all of our students to apply for either our priority notification deadline or our early notification deadline in mid-October and mid-November. Like I said earlier, my name is Morgan Logan. I'd be more than happy to answer any other questions that you guys have. My email address and my phone number are located at the bottom of the slide. Thank you so much for your attention this evening, and hope to connect with you soon.
Hey, Morgan, great. Thank you so much for sharing and presenting on Lenoir-Rhyne today. As we have a few more minutes left in our time together, now that we finished our 6x6 presentations, I'd love to do a little Q&A. This is also a great time for our attendees to ask any last questions in the Q&A box, and also make sure you're grabbing the contact information of the different representatives from the chat that should be being sent out to you. So you can copy, paste that, open a website, and make sure you have the information so you can follow up and ask questions later. Thank you everybody for coming back on screen. Really appreciate it. All right, so the question we're gonna go with is, what is your favorite event or a tradition on campus that kind of gives a little extra peek at the student experience on your campus? We're gonna go in the same order that you presented. So we're gonna then, just as the person ahead of you finishes, just turn on your mic and feel free to answer the question. We'll just go around in a group. So we're gonna start with Florida International.
All right, yes, thank you. Perfect. So favorite event is definitely something we have called Bayfest. It's a festival, obviously, but it's like a traditional festival. It's one of our more, it's like a concert, but it has food trucks and just everything. And they always have a lot of great artists, like the last one that we had in person. We had Rick Ross. So they always bring big artists to Bayfest, and it's just a really good time. A lot of free giveaways, and again, like food trucks, vendors. It's literally like Coachella at FIU, and it's really dope. So I like it. That's probably my favorite.
Hi, I'm Alexis from Columbia College. My favorite event at CC, I would say, is our Future Koala Day, is what we call it, also AKA Accepted Student Day, but it's basically for students who have been accepted or have confirmed to coming the following school year, and we just kind of go all out. So we basically shower you in gifts, saying congratulations, and it's just kind of wrapping up the final year and just allowing you to celebrate this huge milestone. But kind of same thing, we'll have a picnic out on the green is what we call it. We'll have food trucks, alumni will come down, current students will put out, you know, student organizations. So it's just a really fun time, and faculty will bring their kids and stuff like that. So it's just a really big campus community event.
one of the weird, strange, kind of unique celebrations at Wake Forest is actually called Rolling the Quad. So this space that you see behind me, there are trees on either side of Wake Chapel. And after our big athletic victories, our students will go out to this space and throw toilet paper in the trees. It started as a prank a very long time ago when we were actually in Wake Forest, North Carolina, and it has stayed with us. And so when we beat some of those teams in blue, in Durham and in Chapel Hill, you might know who I'm talking about, the ACC. Typically those, yeah, we show up to the quad and there's toilet paper all over the place. So definitely something unique for Wake Forest.
So one of my favorite events for CBU, well, it's when our students decide to officially commit to CBU. So we bring the student on campus. We like to have them pose for an embarrassing photo, but we like to shower them with gifts as well, take a picture with their parents. But I really like that just because it shows like the community aspect of CBU, where we feel like a family. So from the start of students committing to CBU, we want you to know that we're there for you. So we bring all of the admissions people out to cheer the student on. So it's a fun, embarrassing time.
I have two. One is just sandstorm on game day when someone scores a touchdown or beginning of the game. All the 82,000 plus fans in our stadium will get their rally towel and just jump and go crazy. And then the second one is Chicken Finger Wednesdays. On each Wednesday in the dining hall, there's chicken fingers. And it's not about the food, it's about the fellowship.
And my favorite event at Lenoir-Rhyne is Midnight Pancake Breakfast, which happens every exam week. Whole community comes out, everyone gathers in the caf at midnight to eat a lot of pancakes with syrup and whipped cream. It's a great time.
I just love hearing about all of these events and traditions. I hope that everyone who's listening, either live or watching the recording, thinks about Googling it, checking it out, go see pictures. I'm sure it's all over everybody's social media. And maybe you can give you a little extra moment to say, oh, I can picture myself there. I can see myself participating in that because it's awesome. Well, thank you everybody for being a part of tonight's event. I really appreciate it. And we got to hear from six great schools. Thank you to our attendees for their Q&A questions, for everyone watching at home for taking the time out to learn about these great programs. We are coming to the end of our time together tonight. So as we do that, first of all, I do want to say especially thanks to our panelists. You each did a great job. Not just sharing the logistics and those facts and figures of the college admission process, but all of the unique energy, passion that you have for the student experience in your community, at your school, both in and out of the classroom. For everyone who's watching, I hope this is inspiring you to think about reaching out to these counselors, asking them questions. They are your number one resource for your college search journey. So spend that time, build those relationships, and get to know everything you can about the schools. And I hope you're going to check out these six more after today. Thank you again. And when you close your window, we are going to have a very quick little survey. It's just four questions. We'd appreciate any feedback that you would share with us. And again, this is just one of many sessions that have been hosted as a part of the Probe programming. So be sure to check out this session's recording and all other session recordings in about a week's time. You can find it at the same website where you registered, and that will be strivescan.com/probe. That's it for us tonight. I hope you all have a great day and good luck in your college journey. Thanks again. Bye.